Another problem with the saw. First day back in a while. The size of this pad, man, this is a big pad. Ha! So we had to fly through a layer of fog. I think a few hours before the sun kind of comes up and it starts to cook. So what I got to do first thing in the morning here, I got to follow these couple trees below the pad right into here. So it's going to be kind of sketchy. And then I got that big one, this big hemlock here. If you look, top is broken. And if you look at the butt, I bet you there's some rot in the middle there. So I'm hoping it's leaning away. If it doesn't lean away, if it's leaning back this way, I gotta throw it right down in here, right above this pad here. So it's gonna be kind of close. So we'll see. Just hope it don't hit the pad. And then work that way a little bit till I get too close to my partner. And then I'm gonna be jumping over here, working some sideline somewhere in there in the bushes. So try and throw some stuff out this way, not hit the pad. Oh man. Okay. Start that one over there. Nice. Good way to start the morning. Okay. So I had to switch shirts. I got a new shirt. Oh, cool me down. So I got a big mess here. I don't know, for some reason they had a top go above the face there and they brushed up this tree here. Oh, they brushed, yeah, this one's really brushed up, so got a bit of a mess to clean up. Oh. I was gonna leave the camera there, but I decided not to. I guess I was wrong. The faller ended up cleaning up his mess. It just looked bad from my vantage point back there. It was actually, it's pretty good. He actually all cleaned all this up already, so. Which is what you're supposed to do. Clean up your mess if you know someone else is gonna be coming in here, or you know, coming into that spot, just courtesy, clean up your mess. So this guy doesn't have to clean up your mess. So let's hope I don't hit the pad. I aimed it for right there. So if it does go high, it shouldn't hit the pad. See what happens here. Yeah, go figure. It went a little low. That's okay, still easy to back. Once I clean off this spikes here, then I'll put camera on there. Okay, so I'm gonna chance it and leave my axe up here. And hopefully I don't get benched.
Ah.
Look at that, eh? Isn't that cool looking? Look at the fog down there. Look how steep this ground is. Man, is this ever steep? Look at all that wood down there. All that nicely bucked wood. Yeah, good job. Nice looking stumps. This wasn't me, this was someone else. But look how steep and gnarly the ground is. Look at this. We got pretty much a bluff right here. Drops down probably 30 feet right there, all the way up to here. There's right there, all the way down to right down there. Like that's, man, that's like steeper than 45 degrees. 45 degrees is like right here. No, right there. So ground is like way down there. Kind of hard to tell on camera, but man, it's steep. Okay, so you know what that means? DT, danger tree. Well, it means danger tree, but what they're actually pointing at is a widowmaker. Let me just zoom in. Oh, gotta get my balance here. Eating alive by mosquitoes here. That widowmaker right there. So, it looks like this tree's got slightly in that way. Ton of limbs on the low side. They're all on the low side. A lot of downhill weight. If I throw it down there, I'm just gonna smash the pieces. If I throw it that way. I'm gonna see if I can maybe put it down right where my last tree went, right there. Just gonna think, this might be quite a bit of wedging here. We do have a jack at the pad. I think maybe with that limb weight, it'll help me go that way. I think so. I got my big axe. I can always get the jack if I need to. Yeah, because look at that. It just drops right off right there. Like, look at that tree growing right on the side of the bluff. There's my partner way at the far corner over there. He's falling trees that way. Okay, so this was natural. You see, it broke off right there. So this is natural. I thought maybe one of the fallers there had a tree go the wrong way or something, but nope. Yeah, drops off. Yeah, 10, 15 feet right down there. Doesn't look like it, but it's a long ways down. Oh, there it goes. That whole thing will fly. Man, I'm getting eaten alive by bugs here. Okay, I gotta keep moving. Okay, yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna try and wedge this thing that way. I'm not so sure about this. Middle's a bit rotten. We'll see how it goes here. Someone's filing up and keying the mic. You hear my muff? Someone's keying the mic while they're filing up. Oh man, that's way down there. That is way down there. Oh man. See? I ripped out like a foot and a half of rotten holding wood. That big Dutchman had in there. I screwed that up. Oh man. The reason I got my wedge out the far side here is I figured once the tree went, it'll drop off way down there and I have to chase after it. Oh, boy, that's way down there. Oh, there's a log right there. There's a stump way up there. Way up there is a stump. Yeah, at least it's buckable. Well, it looks like it might be a bit of a drop right in the middle there. Yeah, I'll have to see what I can do here. Okay, I don't have my tripod here. I left it up at our next tree up the hill. So I had to cut a little slot in a piece of wood here. Hold the camera.
Yeah.
At least I'm still in the shade. It's like my mountain shade's gone now. Losing my mountain shade, now I'm gonna be getting, hold on, I got a lanyard here in the way. Yeah, okay, so you see the sun's just coming up over the hill there now. It's just coming up over the hill, and then I'll have a little bit of tree shade, and then I'll be in the sun. At least we started early. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, you see that balsam right on that rock face there? I'm gonna climb down there and fall that one out of the way. Let me see if I can get a better vantage point here. Whoa. There we go, that's better. See, it's right on that. Just drops off right down, right up there. Yeah, so I gotta shimmy down that rock there and see if I can get that thing to come right where I'm standing, if I can. Oh yeah, there's the sun right there.
That's cool breeze.
Look at that huge snag right there. Huge. Yeah, it's a big one. Okay, so now it's time to get this big hemlock. See this defect here? I bet you in the middle is all hollow or really, really rotten. No fiber strength to it. I think I got a defect right down there. All right in there. You don't often get hemlocks this big. Hemlocks rot fast when they die. We got here just under 18 feet circumference. That's at about just under 6 feet, probably 5.5 feet diameter, somewhere in there. Luckily, it doesn't have a terrible downhill lean, and I think, let me just see. We got here, kind of not leaning anyway. Because I wanted to put it right down there. But I don't want to hit the pad. I don't know what I'm going to do now. Let me just think here. I'll do the old plumb bob trick here. I should go with this right in center. Center of the tree. Oh yeah. Get this off for a sec. Okay, so I'm plumb bobbed both sides, and it's got a bit of a downhill lean that way. And most of the limbs are on the low side, which is the bad side, because it's gonna lean towards the pad. But on this side, it's leaning that way. So that way and down, which is right where the pad is. So I'm gonna go get the jack, and I'm gonna fall it. I'm gonna bore it too, just to see how much rot there is. But I wanna get it, so I'm just on the low side of that. Maybe even aim right for that, because gravity will probably pull it down a bit. But I'm gonna use the jack. I'm probably gonna use the jack even Well, yeah, I'll use a jack. I might not need it, but I have it all set up in the tree, ready to go. Because I want to make sure I leave a lot of holding wood on this side so it doesn't tear off and go downhill. Okay, that's what I'm going to do.
Thank you.
Well, I didn't make my undercut big enough, so I had to redo it a bit. And there's quite a bit of rot in the high side, so I got a bunch of things against me. Leaning downhill, rot in the high side, pad in the way. So you can see how I went kind of level here. And then from there, I went up. My cut went up a bit. Okay. Maybe I'll cut a little bit down there to get this face opened up a bit. But here's the undercut right there. Giggle is in right there. Yeah. We'll see here.
Oh.
What's going on here? Okay. Sure, it's still recording.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Let's double check here.
I'll show you what I got going on here. I don't know if it's a 20 ton or 40 ton. I don't know. But it's not in the greatest spot, because if you look directly above it, it's a defect right there. So I don't know if a slab's gonna just break off from the pressure of the jack or not. I don't know. But we'll see. Yeah. So if it breaks off, see right to the pad. So I got it going right for that stump right there. If I could smash it on that stump. I think this is a piece of junk anyways. There's nothing good in it. So if I could smash it on that, that'd be pretty entertaining. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Think it's going. It's creaking and groaning. It's going. I can see top moving slowly. I hope you guys didn't hear that. It's not us, it's someone else in the, some other loggers down the valley using the same channel. Oh yeah, I should get really easy, Jack, now. Wow. Wow. Look at that. Look at that. Good thing I left a whole bunch of holding wood there, because I was aimed it right for there. And sure enough, I knew it was gonna, gravity was gonna pull it down. Yeah, look at that, eh? It all nicely cut up there. Big step there, but that's fine. Ton of holding wood there, a lot of rotten wood though. Perfect. I have to clean up some branches. Clean up some of those branches so they're not close to the rotor from the chopper. I mean, that's probably fine as it is, but I'll just do it just cause. Just to be extra safe. But yeah, whole thing's garbage, look at that. Whole thing's garbage. But the government wants us to cut it down. This is government ground. And this is up for bid, you know? The government puts these lots up for bid. So this government owns this land. And then whoever won the bid now owns the wood. So it's kind of a shame we have to fall trees that we know are garbage and they're safe to leave. But then we get penalized for waste if we buck shorter than 3 meters, but we got to fall a whole green tree like that. So it's kind of contradictory how the government and their policies, it doesn't make sense. Some buddy's calling me. Yeah, it's all good. I'm gonna be moving away now, so you're all clear. Yeah, okay. I guess I do have that one more hemlock to throw above the pad, and then I can jump over to the other side, but I can jump over there right now. I got pinched again. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Nice. Look at the holding wood. Nice level stump. I was going to bore it, but yeah, because they didn't need to. Yeah, it worked out great. Right on. Well, let's clean off these slivers here first. Okay, let's go buck this thing.
Thank you. Amen.
Whew, that was a lot of bucking. Dusted some ground there, some dirt, so I had to touch her up. Seems to be cutting even better now. There we go, zoomed in. Oh man, still got tree shade. What a lifesaver. I thought we'd be in the sun by now. 2.5 hours of quitting time, so it's good. So I get these two smaller balsams, down there, down there. Oh, look at, I'll be jumping way over there next. So it looks like I'll be in the sun pretty soon. Right on. Still foggy down there. All that sea fog. It's open ocean out there. Okay, I'm just gonna, I just went left-handed. Nice. Yep, right on. I'm loving the cutoff arms. Oh, I should have done this years ago. Oh, it feels so nice. Just that little bit of difference from the sleeves. Ah, right on.
Ah.
Okay, so my weight card was on my phone, and just a little bit too heavy to go to the next longer length of a 6'3". Gotta go down to a 4'2". One more at a 4'2". It'd be a little bit of a light 4'2", but if I go 6'3", it'll be too heavy. Actually, I changed my where should I put it? Maybe I'll put it right here. Put on this piece of wood. This log hardly has any taper to it. Well, it is a short piece. Wouldn't expect it to taper much. Okay. Oh, I turned it off for now. I don't think the rest of the pieces are gonna drop. So I gotta clean up the little stuff over there and see if this one's coming back my way. We'll see. Okay, so I'm right on the sideline. There's a pad way up there. Way up there. Just trying to see what I can do here. There's a big kind of a draw, like a gradual draw right here. Like this. And there's a sideline way over there in the sun. Right. There's a boundary. Oh, come on now, focus. What's going on? Anyways. So it goes, it looks like the line, so there's a ribbon right here. It's broken off. I guess this was ribboned out quite a while ago because the ribbon's kind of brittle. But it goes down and then shoots over. I'm guessing the ribbon goes above these two big ones. It goes over sideways like this. And look at these huge snags. Oh man, it's bugs. Look at that huge snag there. Not this one, but the one back there. Look at that. Oh. Leaning down the hill. That'd be cool to fall that one. That'll make a big crash. Can't do it right now. See, I can't really throw like this hemlock. Man, it's tall. It's probably sound. It's very healthy looking. There's not a branch on it until like 80 feet up. And then it's only on the low side, so it's a lot of high-grade wood in here. But if I wanted to put in that opening, I kind of got to throw it uphill a bit. And then the butt's probably going to drop way down there. It's not ideal. Better off to throw it that way, right there. But all this here is going, so I don't want to have a bunch of bucked wood pressed up against those trees there. Man, if you look at that, I don't know if you can see it, but 40, 50 feet up in the sunlight, there's like hundreds of bugs flying around. Good thing they're up there, not down here. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do right now. So I don't wanna make a mess for whoever's gonna come up into here. Because those guys way down there and off to the left, below a ledge. I used to think that's what it is, a ledge. I don't know. It's a grade break down there anyway. So, and then this one here, this is even bigger. This has got to be like 5 feet. Another nice high grade piece. But this one's leaning back that way. And like, I could throw it below that tree I was just at, throw it below there, and then lay up against that tree, that bigger hemlock right down there. That would be probably the best thing to do with it. But of course I can't do it now. Not really sure what I'm gonna do here. Cause then I could go over here. This is Devil's Club. All the spikes on there. It smells real nice though, Devil's Club. Apparently you can make a tea out of the roots of the Devil's Club. Yeah, I'm not really sure. I think I might. Like, there's a high stump right there. Whoever made the high stump was smart. To stop stuff from rolling down. Because it gets pretty steep up there. So I might go over there and fall some stuff above the pad back that way. Not much time left in the day. And then I don't have to worry about making a mess for someone who has to come up from below. There's another ribbon there. So the line kind of goes up. Yeah, it goes straight up that bluff, little bluff right there. Goes to the left side of that tree. And then goes up. Nice and cool in the shade. Quite the temperature difference in the shade. I'll show you this little devil's clip here. Look at that. Yeah, even the underside of these leaves got spikes on them. See? Right to the very end. Okay. I'll come up with a plan and then turn the camera back on. Oh yeah. Damn, it did hit that tall stump. Oops. Oops. I wanted to go just below that one. I even shaved the stump in case I clipped it. Yeah, you know, shaved it down a little bit. Still hit it hard. See, I don't want to go above it. I don't want to go above that stump because then the pad's right there.
I didn't want to angle it down here, and then if gravity pulled it down, it'd make a huge mess into those trees there. I didn't want to do that. But I should have aimed it down a little bit more. I should have. Yeah, I kind of screwed that one up a bit. There's a little bit of breakage, but it was a clean break. I'll just buck it out. There's still lots of good wood in here though. Yeah, let me move over here so you can see where it is. Right there, you see? So it broke right there, shattered. So a bucket right there. And then this piece here, that might fly if a bucket right there, and the whole thing might fly, that butt piece. So it's probably 10 feet. But there's still a whole bunch of wood up here to go. Yeah. I was too scared of going too high and hitting the pad and going too low and making a big mess down there. So, oh well. Once again, the Husky has failed me. Doesn't want to run. New fuel filter, spark plug's in good shape. I can get it started, but it won't run. It's not even that old of a saw. Driving me nuts. Another problem with the saw. Usually I fix it myself, but I don't know enough about the 572. I know the 372 and the 390 inside and out, but not the 572. What a headache, man. So frustrating. You got, I don't know, 15 minutes to quitting time. And I got to finish bucking this, pack over to the pad. Drive me nuts. I don't know what to do. Halfway through a cut. Oh, one of those days.